What's up, everyone? Carlos here. So a trailer for Thor Ragnarok just came out, so let's see what was shown. So it starts off with Thor being chained up and hanging in some type of pit. So he goes on to explain how he ended up there. Now it seems like an army led by Hela, played by Cate Blanchett, is attacking Asgard. She even ends up breaking Thor's mighty hammer. Then Asgard gets overwhelmed and Thor gets captured and sent to the other side of the universe to a planet called Sakaar. Now, without his mighty hammer and his army to help him, Thor is all alone. We even get to see Loki, who is played by Tom Hiddleston, and even Heimdall, played by Idris Elba, appear in the movie. So that's great to bring back previous characters for this movie. Now, after Thor is captured, he's been forced to fight as a gladiator for the Grand Master, which is played by Jeff Goldblum. Now, they don't give us any footage of other enemies during the gladiator battles, but the main event is the best part. It puts Thor up against the Incredible Hulk, and it seems like Thor is happy about this because they know each other. So maybe he thinks the Hulk won't fight him, but it turns out that the Hulk is here to fight. So that's going to be an interesting part in the movie. Now, I also noticed that Loki was sitting in the same room as the Grand Master, so it's hard to say what his role is at this part of the film. I think it could be one of two scenarios. Either Loki helped in the attack on Asgard to possibly get revenge, but I don't think he'd want to rule Asgard after it's all burnt down, but maybe it was just a way to get back at his father and also Thor in some way, so he could just be there to watch the battle for his amusement. Now, he could also have some type of agreement with the Grand Master. Perhaps Loki could be a hero in this movie, and he might be watching the tournament, and if Thor wins, he might be allowed to take him back and return to Asgard, at least if there's anything left of it by this time. Now, in the past, Loki was presented as a villain in some way, but because of his character being manipulative and deceiving, he sometimes does things for his own reasons, and they don't actually follow the plan of Thor or anyone else. So it's hard to say what Loki is doing with the Grand Master at this point of the film. Now, I like the trailer a lot, and I think this might be the most action-packed Thor movie so far, and you can see they're going to have quite a bit of visual effects in the film. So the casting list also shows that Dr. Stephen Strange is also going to appear in the movie, along with Thor's father, Odin. And the logo for the movie has that classic 80s look to it, and I like it. So the movie is looking pretty good, and it's got me hyped. So what do you think of the trailer? Put your thoughts in the comment section. Thanks for watching. My name is Carlos, and I'll see you in the next video.